A good day everyone, this is Derek aka Video Cobra from Video Lifestyle once again. Now some time ago, I showed you the handheld gimbal, the SG Flycam version 1. And today I have here with me the SG Flycam version 2. This is a very much more robust built handheld gimbal. And I'm going to show you how and why it is a much better built gimbal. The SG Flycam version 2 has all the similar functions and features as the version 1, but it is improved. We have upgraded a few features, and at the same time, we have made a couple of changes to the tilt function. We've made a couple of changes for balancing, for ease of use and balancing the gimbal. So without much ado, let's get into it. All right, the same similar process as the V1. The V2, what you are going to see here is we've added a little level stand that allows you to just leave the gimbal on a flat surface. And once you leave this on a flat surface, like just like that, and when you power up the gimbal, that allows the gimbal to go into an initialization process. And that will ultimately send a signal to the control board, and that will make the gimbal balance itself. So first of all, I'm going to power up the gimbal. But before you do that, remember, you have to remove the lens cap. Now this is vital because everybody thinks just a lens cap on the camera does not make a difference, but it does make a difference. Make sure your gimbal is stabilized on the table. Now this is possible, of course, with the stand that we have upgraded and modified here. So it's gonna lie level, and this is the time where you power up the gimbal. Now I'm gonna power up the gimbal now, and you will see that there is a red light and followed by a green light. And then after that, the gimbal is going to go into a fast green continuous blink. Now once this starts, that means you can lift the gimbal off the table and you can use your dial, there you go, to adjust the tilt of the camera, and the gimbal is actually stabilized. So this is very much similar to the version 1 of the Flycam, but these are the improvements. The cage, or the camera cage, is also very much more robust compared to the version 1. Now if you're using Canon SLRs, DSLRs, it's perfect because you've got the... you can secure your camera on the bottom, from the bottom, as well as the top. So this is the advantage. The other features that you find, of course, with the gimbal is, of course, the third axis follow. So if you do a pan, you will see that the camera is following. When you do a pan, there you go, it's followed. Once I go to middle, look, it's followed back to the middle. If I tilt the camera upwards, the camera is gonna go up. When I tilt it down, there you go, it's gonna go down. So this is a gimbal that I would recommend definitely for those smooth cinematic shots. And of course, we are going to do a couple more improvements as we go along. Like for example, better aesthetic on the handles as well as the low angle handle. Recommendation is to power it up with a 4S battery. That will give you easily over an hour of operations, you know, with this particular handheld gimbal. Now, just in case your gimbal goes whack, or you know, you have a little bit of an issue, it doesn't stabilize properly, you can use this initialization switch. Press it once and leave it a while. Go through the process of the cycle of the LED signals, and then there you are, lift it up, it'll be fine. The dial, which I like to show you over here, this is the control where the tilt is, and this is placed here, as you can see, very, very, very strategically, so that you can use the gimbal while holding the handles at the same time tilting the camera. Oh, one last thing I forgot to mention. We are not saving any costs in terms of the reliability. Therefore, the gimbal is powered by the Alexmos controller board, the 3-axis controller board. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. I'm going to show you a couple of sample shots now done with this gimbal. I hope you enjoy it. And yeah, if you're interested, just drop us a line.